Hey, it's Mike here, and today, grass-fed beef. In particular, we're going to examine whether or not it is eco-friendly or healthy, like everybody seems to believe. As usual, we're gonna look at research, we're gonna look at some environmental studies, do some greenhouse gas math, look at some nutrient profiles and some labeling laws. Let's just go, let's get right into it. First, let's look at the labeling situation because that affects all of the other issues, and you probably already know that just because a piece of meat has the label grass-fed on it doesn't mean that that animal lived their entire life on pasture or was fed grass for their entire life. In 2016, the FDA officially backed away from fully regulating this, from fully overseeing this issue. And so now the term grass-fed is quite easy to get on your label. And this means that you can feed an animal grass for a portion of their life, feedlot, finish them on grain, or give them grass pellets in a feedlot their entire life. And to emphasize this, speaking to the current labeling laws, quote, like other mostly meaningless label terms, grass-fed will become just another feel-good marketing ploy used by the major meat packers to dupe customers into buying mass-produced grain-fed feedlot meat. That is from the American Grass-Fed Association. Not a vegan organization. Not an evil vegan agenda there. So people are being sold the fantasy of grass-fed where it doesn't necessarily exist. And yeah, this is important in terms of other issues, like if it's not actually a grass-fed animal, then the environmental impacts will be different. But I also don't want to rely solely on this argument. I'm going to be making real arguments on the math for actual grass-fed animals. All right, let's go. All right, going right into the environmental stuff. People love to say that grass-fed cows help the planet, that they're good for the environment. And yes, I am saying cows, knowing that a cow specifically means a female bovine. But it's easier to say, and I swear if somebody is like, nothing in this video is valid because this guy doesn't even know the difference between a cow and cattle. So resume head in sand. But in terms of that grass-fed environmental impact, something I will never hear grass-fed proponents like Alan Savory say or anybody admit, and that is the methane emissions from this study. They were over 3 times as high from grass-fed cows than they were from grain-fed cows, about 3.3 to be specific. And methane is a very powerful greenhouse gas in terms of the CO2, carbon dioxide equivalent, of how much it warms the atmosphere over a 100-year time period. The standard amount from the EPA, we're looking at 28 to 36 times the power of CO2. And it's worth noting that from that study, those methane emissions from those grass-fed cows were actually a little bit on the lower end. They were lower than average. Maybe it had to do with the type of pasture they were on. But a common figure is 70 to 120 kilograms of methane per year per cow. That study found that it was about 84. Well, the average is about 95. And so that average translates to about 209 pounds of methane per year, which might not seem like a lot. But remember, we're talking about that 28 to 36 times more powerful than CO2, and then we have that 1.4 billion cow population globally, according to the United Nations. So it gets pretty massive. So if we reach that eco grass-fed dream and we're able to shift all of our cows to grass-fed, then we would be looking at 10.5 trillion pounds of CO2 equivalent per year, and that's about 4,800 million metric tons, which is a more commonly used unit for measurements of this scale. If you were to compare all of those grass-fed cows to countries, they would be almost tied just behind the US as the second highest emitting country on planet Earth, and they're easily going to beat the entire European Union's emissions. Grass-fed beef's like so eco. But don't worry, it gets way worse because a grass-fed cow takes way longer to get to slaughter weight than a grain-fed cow does directly from the cattle industry. A quote, feedlot animal becomes ready for slaughter at 12 to 13 months of age. A grass-fattened animal is often ready for slaughter at 18 and upwards of 24 months. Now that's 150 to 200% of the time. It's unclear exactly what population of our cattle are currently grass or grain-fed, but it seems that about 94 to 97% are feedlot finished on grain. So we can go with a, you know, fair estimate of a 50% increase in cattle population. Let's go and look at the conservative figure of 2.1 billion. Well, they would emit 7,200 million metric tons of CO2 equivalent per year, surpassing the US easily. And while it doesn't quite reach China's emissions, it would be easily the second highest emitting country on Earth. And that's just looking at burps alone. This is not an eco-friendly solution, but also want to mention, don't mistake this for me supporting grain-fed. Everybody believes that grain-fed is also bad. We feed from the FAO up to half of humanity's grain to livestock. And from this study, there's also the nitrous oxide issue, where in feedlots from the waste, you can emit nitrous oxide, which is up to almost 300 times as powerful a greenhouse gas as CO2. Not fun. But back to methane, I do think it's worth looking at that 20-year time frame just to understand, because we care about what happens in the next 20 years to planet Earth, and methane is even more powerful because it's a, you know, quick and strong greenhouse gas, and so we're looking at about 72 to 105 times as powerful as CO2 over a 20-year time period. So that changes all the equations a bit, but just keep that in mind. Now, I know some people are probably gonna be like, yeah, Mike, what about seaweed though? Seaweed is the answer. I read that it completely reduces all methane emissions from cows, so I'm just gonna keep eating as much as I want now, even though seaweed isn't fed to like any cows. Firstly, the figures that people latch onto are massively exaggerated. You may have seen articles like this one from The Independent claiming 99% less emissions from cows fed seaweed. Firstly, they didn't even look at cows directly. The exact title of The Independent article is, quote, "Feeding cows seaweed cuts 99% of greenhouse gas emissions from their burps, research finds." Independent with the trash reporting. No, that research didn't even look at actual cows, but they knew that title would get clicks. They're talking about this study that looked at sort of the methane emissions from bacteria in the digestive system of cows when they added seaweed in a Petri dish. You know, the study even says these are in vitro, not in vivo or from live cows, saying that the results haven't been confirmed. Research that looked at a few cows found that it was more in the realm of a quarter to half of a reduction in methane emissions. And to achieve that would be a massive undertaking. It would mean growing a huge amount of seaweed, having seaweed farms, shipping it all over, and there could be other problems, including atmospheric ones there. One scientist, Andy Reisinger, who has been studying this issue since before these headlines, says there might be some hiccups with it. Firstly, that the methane is actually neutralized by bromoform, which is from this seaweed, and that has been shown to be able to cause holes in the ozone. So one atmospheric problem for another. And furthermore, that we cannot control the release of this bromoform into the atmosphere on seaweed farms, which we would need in order to accomplish this. There's also a widespread concern from anyone that's actually looked at this issue that it might just not be feasible large scale, and that's been echoed by several people. On Australian news, they were talking about getting enough seaweed to feed a million cows. How about 2.1 billion cows. It's also worth noting that bromoform is a suspected carcinogen and could possibly bioaccumulate in these cows anyway. What bothers me the most about this is it's telling people good news about their bad habits once again, and it's sort of akin to telling people that they should just buy SUVs and that SUVs are great because there exists a Tesla SUV that gets 94 miles per gallon equivalent. Buying a Cadillac Escalade right now is not going to help the environment because there's a Tesla SUV. Buying grass-fed beef right now is not going to help the environment because seaweed might help. No. All right, I haven't even talked about the land use, so let's get into that. Globally, we use about 30% of our ice-free land for livestock, and in the US, we use almost half of the lower 48's land for livestock. And the exact amount of land required to graze any one animal completely depends on the environment and other factors. But the question is, how much more land would we need if we shifted over to grass-fed? The answer is too much. Just looking at the actual breakdown on this chart, only about 16% of the land that is used for animal agriculture is specifically used for growing feed. The rest, the other 84%, is used for grazing. So imagine potentially doubling that population or massively increasing it and eating up even more of the land that we have. Way too much. This huge demand leads to a lot of deforestation. Looking to the Amazon rainforest estimates, like this one from Greenpeace, say about 80% of Amazon destruction is from livestock. That is ridiculous. We don't need to deforest more lands, which lowers their ability to sequester carbon and then emit methane instead. It's insane. And just for some contrast from this study, a vegan diet uses only about 1/6 of the land as a standard diet. Growing plants is the most efficient way. All right, next. All right, now let's look at the health. Is grass-fed beef the sort of health food that it's made out to be? Well, right off the bat, regardless of how an animal is fed, if they are a cow, they have red meat, which is a class 2A carcinogen. And I don't really know of any carcinogen that's also a health food. Plutonium. It's sugar-free. Furthermore, you've probably been led to believe that grass-fed beef or animal flesh is a good source of omega-3s. The reality is, it's absolutely not. Well, the ratio is slightly better looking at this chart of Texas A&M data in Beef Magazine. We're only looking at, for a 4-ounce steak, about 55 milligrams of ALA, which is also the omega-3 present in plants, and from just one serving of chia, we're looking at 5,300 milligrams, so this is laughable, not nutritionally comparable, and it's a total joke. There's literally 100 times more, yet I can still imagine somebody just in a restaurant eating grass-fed beef that they just paid like $20 for, eating that steak and being like, oh, it feels so good to get all those omegas. 50 milligrams! And on that same page, they also compare the saturated fat content. These are very comparable. They're even claiming that the saturated fat is higher in grass-fed beef. Either way, it is high. And if you really want to, you can get lean cuts of grain-fed meat as well, so this isn't really an important conversation. The idea is, between all these things together, the carcinogenic nature, the total lack of omegas, and the saturated fat that's still there, nope. Not a health food, sorry. Moving on. Just a quick ethical point. People say, oh, these are cows on pastures, everything's perfect, yay, cows are being, you know, massaged in oil and do yoga and all that stuff. No, absolutely not. First of all, we've seen the labeling issue. And second of all, no matter how an animal is raised, they are still being killed way young and being killed against their will. You know, whether it's 12 months on a grain-fed diet or 24 on a grass-fed diet, that's still, you know, in terms of lifespan, equivalent to a 5 to 10-year-old human. You know, it's still kind of killing a child. And several times throughout this video, I've tried to make a point of mentioning that beef is, in fact, animal flesh, because from this study, looking at 9 to 12-year-olds in urban areas, 40% of them don't know that beef comes from cows, and that's not an accident. And one quick point about Alan Savory, I've done two old videos on him which need to be updated. You know, he's very much cows are what we need to save the planet. The reality is, even if you are sequestering some carbon with these cows, you know, you sequester one molecule of carbon, but if you have another molecule of carbon that is being burped out, and that becomes 36 times more powerful of global warming gas than that one that you sequestered, you have a problem. You have to be sequestering absurd amounts of carbon to offset that methane damage. In the end, grass-fed animal flesh is not eco-friendly in terms of methane emissions. It is through the roof, and if we go grass-fed, we're gonna have to have even more of these animals emitting even more methane. And no, seaweed won't save us, and the grass feeding of animals, the pasture raising of animals, uses even more land, causes even more deforestation. And I didn't even mention the desertification, it never ends. And it's not a health food, it's a carcinogen with virtually no omega-3s and still a pretty good source of saturated fat, which clogs arteries. If you don't believe that, watch all of the videos that I've done on that. And finally, you're still killing a young animal against their will. Totally not okay. All right, that's it for today. Feel free to let me know what you think down below. Feel free to like, subscribe, and thank you for watching.